My dear students, today we are going to study unit 1 of your English practice book. In this unit, we'll be studying some of the basic or crucial elements of English grammar. In this unit, we'll be studying nouns, adverbs, adjectives, etc. Without much delay, let's begin worksheet first. Read the following passages and make a list of the proper nouns, common nouns, and abstract nouns in the passages in appropriate columns given on the next page. What you have to do is to read the passages carefully and pick up proper nouns, common nouns, and abstract nouns. Proper nouns are the particular name or specific names given to place, person, or thing. Similarly, common names given to place, person, or thing are known as common noun, and abstract nouns are those nouns or those naming words which are given or attributed to qualities, feelings, state of mind, attitudes, etc., that we cannot touch or we cannot see. Remember, proper nouns are special names or specific names or particular names. For example, Ganga, Ram. Common names are names given to a class of thing. For example, boy, river, city. Abstract names or abstract nouns are the names given to qualities or feelings or state of minds. For example, kindness, beauty, etc. Now, you are supposed to pick up all the proper nouns, common nouns, and abstract nouns from within the given passage. This is to be done by you. Now, here you have columns, proper noun, common noun, and abstract noun. In this passage, you may select Mr. Sunil Arya is proper noun, new city is the name of a city, so it is proper noun, wife refers to class of people, so it is common noun, children refers to common noun, Family refers to common noun. Family is a common noun. New city, this is the name of a city, new city, just like New York. So new city is proper noun. Mr. Arya, this is proper noun. And what is Mr. Arya? Mr. Arya is a scientist. So scientist is common noun for Mr. Arya. Mr. Arya is one of the scientists, not all the scientists. And when we say scientist, means any scientist can be part of scientist. So Mr. Arya is proper noun, scientist is common noun. Laboratory is common noun, home is common noun, machines common noun, inventions common noun, human robot is a common noun, but when we call it seed, when a name given to the human robot seed, then it is seed becomes proper noun. Time machine is कॉमन नाउन, मशीन इज कॉमन नाउन, टाइम मशीन इज प्रॉपर नाउन. रिमेंबर टाइम मशीन नोट इट डाउन इन द प्रॉपर इन द कॉलम ऑफ प्रॉपर नाउन. टाइम मशीन इज प्रॉपर नाउन, वेर एज वेन वी स्पीक मशीन इट इज कॉमन नाउन. ओके, वेन वी कॉल सुपरसोनिक माइक्रोफोन इट इज कॉमन नाउन. When we called it mic or mic, it is proper noun. Scientific gadgets, we can treat it both common noun as well as proper noun. Among the gadgets, if a gadget is particularly meant for scientific research, then that gadget could be treated as a proper noun. But when gadgets we speak simply, then it can be the part of common noun. It could be treated as common noun. However, scientific gadgets too is supposed to be common noun. And when we say microscope, then that again could be the part of common noun. But a specific microscope and a specific name given to a microscope, then that name would be the proper noun. Furthermore, we come across newspapers. Newspapers is a common noun. but when we say Hindustan Times or Times of India, it is proper noun. When we say Dainik Jagran, Hindustan, Nav Bharat Times, it is proper noun. These are proper nouns. But when we call all them put in one category, then that category will be known as newspaper, and newspaper is the name given to a type of things, so that newspaper is a common noun over here. So make your entries appropriately in the columns provided for proper nouns, common nouns, abstract nouns. Now here you have been provided with the definitions of these three basic noun types. Proper noun refers to a particular person, place or thing. Example given: Lata Mangeshkar, Kolkata, The Times of India, The Taj. And one more important thing, that please note that a proper name always begins with a capital letter. It is to be kept in mind that a proper name always begins with a capital letter. Now further, you have a common noun is a name given in common to a person, place or thing of the same class and kind. Example given: boy, girl, man, woman, computer, plane, town, pencil. An abstract noun refers to a quality, idea, experience, feeling, a state which can be thought of or felt but cannot be touched or seen. Kindness, love, fear, beauty, warmth, anger, darkness, heaviness, purity, hatred are some of the names that we cannot touch or cannot see. However, these are the names given to human qualities or human feelings. Next, you have given below are the visuals of some famous people, places and things. Write the names of each of the visuals in column A and what the visual is in column B. The first one has been done for you. Mr. Sunil Arya, scientist. what are we discovering over here? That Mr. Sunil Arya is a proper noun, proper name, proper noun, and his type is or class is, which becomes a common noun, is scientist. Mr. Sunil Arya is a scientist. Scientist is common noun. Mr. Sunil Arya is proper noun. Similarly, we have in next in the sequence, we have another pictorial visual, which is Taj Mahal. Taj Mahal is proper noun, but when we put into the category of monuments, then it monument at column B, you have to write here monument. Monument becomes common noun. Or heritage, if you write instead of monument, if you write heritage, then heritage also becomes common noun. So remember, Taj Mahal, when we speak Taj Mahal, it is proper noun, but when we categorize Taj Mahal into a monument, then monument becomes common noun, because monument is the name given to a type of things, and Taj Mahal is one of the monument type. Likewise, we have Sachin Tendulkar is proper noun, but when we say cricketer is common noun. Likewise, India Gate, proper noun, monument or heritage or monument, it becomes common noun. Vivekanand, in this visual we find Vivekanand over here. Vivekanand is proper noun, and he was a social reformer. So when we say reformer becomes common noun. So all the words you have written in column A are proper nouns, and in column B are common nouns. This is to be noted down. Now here you have crossword puzzle. Try doing yourself. You could do yourself. First you try doing yourself. Then we'll be discussing afterwards. Next you have worksheet 2. Let's know more about the Arya family. Mrs. Arya, a housewife, is a simple and intelligent lady. She is extremely loving and caring. She does all the household chores efficiently. She cooks food patiently, cleans the house every day, washes clothes carefully, takes care of her family, and does all the shopping. She has decorated her home beautifully. She loves reading books and often visits the library. She is generally calm, but sometimes she loses her patience with her husband's inventions. Now underline all the action words given in the above paragraph. What you have to find is action words. Action words means doing words. The words which are used to indicate something being done or something which is done, that we call, you know, verbs. So doing words are verbs, and you have to find out the doing words or the verbs. You have to pick out the verbs from the given passage. So what you have to do is underline the action words from within this passage. Got it? Mrs. Arya is a housewife. Mrs. Arya, a housewife, is a simple and intelligent lady. She is extremely loving and caring. Now, you will be finding over here action words such as is, loving, caring, does, cooks, cleans, washes, takes, does, decorated, loves, visits, loses, so these are that we named, that we called, that we spoke, these were the doing words. Does, cooks, cleans, all such words are doing words in the passage. You have to underline them. Now further you come, all the action words are verbs. Example given, cook, play, smile, etc. Read the passage again and in the box given below list any 5 action words and the words which tell you more about them. How, when, where, how often, etc. The first one has been done for you. Cooks. Now words telling more about the actions. Patiently. See, the word patiently is adding to the meaning of the word or action word cook. Patiently, the word patiently is adding to the meaning of the action word cook over here. So in the right hand side we have to write the words which tell more about the action taken or about the kind of action. For example, decorated is one of the word, action word, and beautifully. So beautifully is the word over here which is adding to the meaning of the word decorated. Decorated is action word and beautifully is adding to its meaning or describing that how the kind of how the word decorated or how the things have been decorated. So decorated is being described by the word beautifully. So what do we discover? That all the words which tell you how, when, where, how often about an action are called adverbs. So patiently, calmly, slowly, quickly, beautifully, all such words are adverbs. Efficiently, happily, cheerfully, etc.